Hi guys, welcome back to another little geeky reviews. This time we are going to go through the tales of Grayskull Teela. I bet you're probably thinking now, how far am I going to go with this line? Who knows, guys, who knows? It's really whichever one calls out to me, whether I end up breaking the bank and going down the whole route, even tracing back wave one if they ever do pop up again. I cannot tell you how far. I'm going to stick with the main Origins lines. But these ones, just whatever calls out to me, they're the ones I'm going to probably get. On the back of Teela, you've got her fighting Merman there. And obviously, she comes with this shell I did mention with Casey Jones. On the last preview, he's got those little knoblets in the back where you can pop a shell in. So let's crack her open and have a little closer look. With it being the same wave as Casey Jones, Teela comes with the actual same comic. Again, EU version, so there is no little speech bubbles in the actual comic itself. So getting her out of the box, she is wearing this helmet. I actually thought the helmet would come off, but it's actually moulded to her head. So yeah, definitely moulded to her head. She has got a little ponytail peeking out the back, which is on a little twisty as well. I'm a bit gutted that they've moulded that helmet. I thought it'd be like Casey Jones, where it'd just slip straight off. But working our way down, so she comes in this pearlized type of green armour. She's got those big old shoulder pads going on. She's got some chain detailing round her waistband with the little flap on the front. While we're in the middle there, she comes with these two shell gauntlets with two little dagger spikes. Now these are just clipped on, so these are actually removable, and it's clips on a little gauntlet. On the back, she has got this little white piece, like little, represents like fur, I suppose. It's quite soft, so it does fold up, and then she's got those little two pinholes there. Now she's got the half shell accessory with, again, the two pegs, which will slot in to the hole there. And then that cloth piece will fold back down. I mean, it's not bad. The actual shell itself, I actually prefer it without, because the cloth piece actually hides the two peg holes as well. Because it does come with a little handle on the back, which can change, obviously, into a shield. And then she comes with this big, massive sword piece as well. So I've had to remove the clip, because with it having this like little dagger in, I mean, that's cool, isn't it, where it's got the actual, where it's tied the actual dagger onto the shell. I've just noticed that bit. Let's see if I can get it on with the shield, so it can clip on with the actual sword hand, but not the actual shield itself, with that little dagger being in the way. Now, it does all the usual things with the Origins, so all like the pop off, head pops off, arm, waist, hands, boots, does all that usual stuff, and it's all the same articulation as well. Let's just have a quick look at what the detail is without the armour. So this is where I'm saying it's a shame that helmet is actually stuck on her head. So, because we could have had another variation of Teela there as well, but that's really, I mean, yeah, it's definitely, it's cut in and stuck in as well. That is an absolute shame. I mean, she's got really, really light skin as well. So if you bring the old Teela in, I mean, it's like Teela in Tenerife and Teela in the UK. That's what you've got. So just bringing in the other Teelas I've got. So you got cartoon Teela. I've got the Teela that come out with Zohar or Zor, whichever you want to, where you want to say it. But again, it's the skin detailing. I was thinking about swapping a head over. So she is probably the lightest one. I've even brought in the sorceress that came at Castle Grayskull. So let's just pop that head off. I think this is the closest skin detailing that we've got. I mean, that, even if, so if you had a spare Grayskull sorceress, I mean, that looks pretty cool without the wings as well. So there you go, guys, there's my little review of the Turtles Teela. Let me know your thoughts in the comments box. While you're there, do the usual with like, subscribe, tickle that little bell notification so you don't miss out on any others. But thanks for checking in on this one, and I will see you on the next. Take care.